name is Louise Steiner, 30-year resident of Santa Monica. Good evening. I am continuing on with a letter from the law offices of Tom Nitti and where Susan Hartley left off. The staff report does not identify any trees as dangerous. How did trees that are beyond their useful life become a danger to the public? How did trees unable to survive a transplant become a danger to the public? How did allegedly diseased trees necessarily become a danger to the public? The city's consulting site arborist, Cy Carlsberg, in her report to the city of January 5th, 2008, identified only three trees as having a high failure potential. The majority of trees in her report were identified as having a low failure potential. Number five, in light of the staff reports, the city's history regarding these trees, it strains credulity to believe that they all suddenly become dangerous at once, and the city's consulting arborist report, as well as contradictory statements by the city forester, too lengthy, too detailed here, but a ripe subject for a deposition. It is my client's position that the removal of 23 trees as a so-called danger to the public would be a violation of the court order. Cordially, Thomas A. Nitti. And speaking from my heart, please do not take the heart and lungs of these trees from us.
Thank you.